Hello children, in the last video we completed with the topic health and hygiene. Okay, in this topic we studied about allergy. Okay, so what is allergy? Allergy is a condition in which the body produces an abnormal immune response to certain substances which are otherwise harmless. Then we saw what are allergens. So an allergen is a foreign substance that is inhaled or eaten and is recognized by immune system as a threat causing abnormal immune response. After that we studied the entry route for allergens, and we saw that the nose, mouth and skin are the different entry routes for the allergens into the body. Symptoms of allergic reaction. Different symptoms are shown by different type of allergies. Okay, so it may differ from the runny nose, coughing, sneezing, wheezing to itching or bumps or burning sensation in the skin, okay, or you may feel like difficulty in breathing, nausea, vomiting, feeling of weakness, fainting, okay. So depending upon the type of allergy, the symptoms of the allergic reactions are observed in the people. There are two types of allergies, that is the seasonal allergy and perennial allergy. Seasonal allergy means the allergy that is occurring only during a particular season, whereas the perennial allergy is the type of allergy which occurs throughout the year. Okay, it is not bounded by a particular season. One more term we studied about anaphylaxis. Sometimes allergic reactions become serious and trigger a life-threatening reaction called anaphylaxis. And the person who is suffering from anaphylaxis is said to have gone into anaphylactic shock. Okay. Lastly, we studied about the preventive measures for allergies. Okay, depending upon the type of allergy you are having, there are different preventive measures. However, one measure is common for all the different types of allergy, and that is avoiding exposure to the allergens and effectively managing daily habits. Okay, these two things can keep you safe from any type of allergy, right? So all these things we studied in this chapter. Now we will be discussing the question answers related to this particular chapter. Okay, so page number 118 of your book, okay, section 1, the first question, name the following. Okay, first one, substances that cause hypersensitivity. Answer is allergens. Entry route of pollen grain in the human body for allergic reaction. Answer is nose. Allergies occurring throughout the year. Answer, perennial allergy. The body system that recognizes the allergens as threat, immune system. Life-threatening reaction caused by severe allergic reactions, anaphylaxis. Question B, write true or false. Correct the false statement by changing the first or the last word. First one, hay fever is also known as allergic rhinitis. True. Scabies is caused by pollen grains. False. Either you write hay fever is caused by pollen grains or you write scabies is caused by mites. Okay, both the answers will be correct. Next, medicine that causes allergies are categorized as non-food allergens. True. An improved immunity can develop resistance against allergens. True. Allergies caused by dust are perennial allergies. True. Okay, fine. Coming to the next one, choose the correct option. Which of the following is an allergen? Answer is C, cotton dust. Penicillin can? Answer is B, trigger allergies. Next, which of the following allergies is caused due to detergents and soaps? Answer is B, skin allergy. Fourth, an allergic reaction that is hereditary. Answer is C, sinusitis. Okay, going to question number D, match the following. Okay, first one, airborne allergen, answer dust. Food allergen, answer peanuts. Anaphylaxis, answer life threatening. Allergy, answer immune response. Hay fever, answer allergic rhinitis. Okay, given below are a list of allergic response. Write the name of the allergens next to them. Okay, so we will be writing only one single allergen name, right? Hay fever, pollen grains. Rashes on the skin, detergents. Vomiting, food allergens. Scabies, mites. Runny nose, dust. Okay, Coming to section 2, differentiate between the following: allergy and allergen. Here you will be writing the definition for allergy and definition for allergen as differentiate between, that is there on page number 112. I'll just show you. See here, this is the definition for allergy, okay, and here is the definition for the allergen. So differentiate between allergy and allergen, you can get the answer from page number 112. Next question is food and non-food allergen. You can write the examples, okay. Like for food allergen you can write dairy product, and non-food allergen you can write dust. Third, seasonal and perennial allergy. Here you will be writing the definition and an example. The answer is on page number 115 and 116. So first we will see what do we mean by seasonal allergy. Okay, page number 114. So here you are having allergies that occur during a particular season are called seasonal allergies. Okay, and the example is allergies caused by pollen grains is one example. Okay, coming on the next page regarding the perennial allergy. Allergies that are not caused due to seasonal factors and may occur throughout the year are called as perennial allergies. Most allergies such as food allergy will be considered as the example of perennial allergy. Okay, so that is about the differentiate between seasonal and perennial allergy. Next is hay fever and scabies. Okay, you can write how the hay fever is caused and how the scabies is caused for this. Allergy caused due to pollen grain is called as hay fever, and allergy caused due to mites is scabies. Okay. Next is anaphylaxis and anaphylactic shock. Basically, you should not have such a type of question in differentiate between because they are related to each other. Okay. But then since it is given, we will be discussing the answer. The answer is on page number 15. Okay. Over here. Sometimes allergic reaction becomes serious and trigger a life-threatening reaction called anaphylaxis. Okay, the person suffering is said to have gone into anaphylactic shock. So anaphylaxis and anaphylactic shock, right? The person suffering from anaphylaxis, you write over here. Okay, the person suffering from anaphylaxis is said to have gone into anaphylactic shock. Okay, so with this we finish with the differentiate between questions. Next we will be going to the short answer questions. The first one is list 5 different types of allergens. So here you can write dust, pollen grains, mites, sunlight, food. Okay, these are the different types of allergens. Next, how do pollen grains cause allergic reaction? The answer is on page number 115. How does pollen grain causes allergic reaction? Okay, page number 115. See here, the answer is the sinuses in the nose become sensitive to pollen grains, causing headache, sneezing, coughing, itchy throat, watery eyes, and blocked or runny nose that may last for weeks. Okay, this way the pollen grains cause the allergy. Okay, page number 115. Next, what are the main pathways for the entry of allergens? So answer is on page number 114 over here. Okay, entry route for allergen. Allergens enter the human body through 3 main pathways: the mouth ingesting the allergen, the nose breathing in the allergen, and the skin allergen rubbing against the skin. Okay, so these are the different entry routes for allergens. Next question. Give an example of seasonal allergy and perennial allergy. So for seasonal allergy you can write hay fever, and for perennial allergy you can write dust allergy. Okay, next, what are the precautions to be taken against dust allergy? Okay, you can wear a mask to protect yourself from dust allergy, right? Coming to long answer questions. First one, what are the symptoms of oral, nasal, and skin allergic reaction? Answer is on page number 114. Okay, over here, under entry route for allergens, the mouth. Okay, isme se aapko sirf symptoms likhna hai. So the symptoms are over here for the mouth: itching or swelling of parts of the mouth, tongue, lips, throat, and the pharynx are common symptoms for oral allergy. Next, for nose, sneezing, coughing, runny nose, and congestion are common symptoms for nose allergy, right? Next, For skin allergy, rashes, severe itching, bumps or hives, redness and blisters are common symptoms of skin allergy. So you need to write the symptoms for the mouth, the nose and the skin allergy. Okay. Next question. What is anaphylaxis? What are the symptoms of it? Page number 115, 115. Okay. Sometimes allergic reactions become serious and trigger a life-threatening reaction called anaphylaxis. Stings of bees, wasps and red ants are likely to trigger anaphylaxis. The person suffering is said to have gone into anaphylactic shock. This condition may lead to difficulty in breathing or bouts of severe coughing. Okay. It can occur suddenly and become fatal. Right. So this is the answer. Fine. The next question is, what causes asthma? How can it be treated? Okay. So pollen grains cause asthma. How can it be treated? That you will be finding over here under seasonal allergies. The second, third and fourth point you can consider. Keep windows and doors shut. Take a shower and change your clothes when you come home. Do not hesitate to wear filter or a mask to cover your nose and mouth while traveling. Okay. Next question. Give example of food allergens. What allergic reaction do they cause? Page number 114. Okay. Over here. Most common food allergens are milk and dairy products, nuts, eggs, gluten based items, mushrooms and seafood. Symptoms of food allergy vary from mild to severe and can be life threatening. Swelling of the lips, tongue, face, stomachache and tingling sensation in the mouth are some of the symptoms of food allergy. Okay, so that is the answer. Next question. Write a note on the preventive measure to be taken against allergies. Answer, page number 116. Okay, so here you are having the answer under preventive measures, point 1, 2, 3 and point number 4. So these points you can write, okay, for preventive measures for allergies. So these were the long answer questions. Coming to the picture study, okay, the first one, identify the type of allergen shown in the picture. Okay, it is pollen grains. What category does this allergen fall into? Non-food allergy. Okay. And you can write about seasonal allergy also over here. Describe the common symptoms that can result due to allergens. So the symptoms are sneezing, runny nose or nose congestion, itchy eyes. Picture study 2. Name the type of allergy and give the symptoms of the allergic reaction shown in the picture. Okay. So here you are having the nasal allergy. You feel difficulty in breathing and mucus accumulation is observed. Second, what could be the possible causative agent of this allergy? Allergens like dust, animal fur, pollen grains. Mention two symptoms other than the one shown here that the person could suffer from: sneezing, coughing. Okay, so this is the answer for the, these are the answers for the second picture study. Third picture study. First one, identify the allergens labeled 1 to 4. 1, pollen grain. 2, mites. 3, animal hair. 4, smoke. What could be the entry route for the allergens number 1, 2 and 4? So 1 is pollen grain, 2 is mite and 4 is smoke. So all their entry route will be nose. Write two symptoms of allergic reactions due to the allergens labeled 2 and 4. Okay. Coughing and runny nose. Next, what precautionary measures can be taken to prevent oneself from such allergies? Okay. So the precautionary measure is avoid exposure to the allergens. Okay. So these were the questions and answers of the chapter Health and Hygiene Allergy. Okay. Mark the answers in your textbook, fine, so that you can study the answers, right? Children, remember that you will have to study the text from the chapter, okay? Because you will be getting the question answers from the text and not from the questions that are present at the end of the chapter. Okay, so you need to study the whole text in detail. Fine? Okay, bye.